Hello, this is the first of two videos on how to configure data logging in the Cogent DataHub. In this first video, we'll use the DataHub to create a new database table, and then we'll configure the DataHub to write a new row to the table each time we log data. This is the most common configuration, and it's useful for storing historical data that can be analyzed by other database client programs. In a second video, we'll read the structure of a table that already exists in the database, and then we'll configure the DataHub to write to the same row in the table each time we log new values. This is useful when you are logging to a database that is part of another office or plant system. So here we are in my Windows 7 system with the Cogent DataHub already running. I've connected to my data source. In this case, it's the top server from Software Toolbox. If we take a look at the data coming into the DataHub, you can see here are the three data points that I've configured to read from the top server, and we'll use these in our data logging example today. I also have a MySQL database installed and running, and we'll use the Workbench tool to view the data that we log from the DataHub into the database. So, to get started, let's click on the data logging icon. By default, the DataHub is set up to store and forward data if the connection is lost to the database. This is very useful when you're connecting to a database that's running on a networked computer. I'm going to go ahead and click on the Configure button, and this will bring up the interface where we configure what is called a configured action. The first thing we need to do is obviously connect to our database. Databases are listed under the drop-down for data source names, and you can see that my database, my SQL database, is already there. If your database is not listed here, you can use the DSN administrator, which is a system resource, and this will allow you to set up a data source name for your ODBC database. So I've selected my database. I will enter my password, or my username and password, and click the Connect button, and you'll see the DataHub has successfully connected to my SQL database. Now, in the next step, we'll take a look at the table definitions. If there are any tables defined within our database, they'll be listed in this drop-down menu here. You can see that right now there are no database tables, so we're going to go ahead and click on Create New Table to make our own table using the DataHub interface. So I'm going to call my table Demo. And again, by default, the DataHub is set up in the most common configuration, which is to add new rows to the table every time we log data. In the next video, we'll look at the other option, which is to modify the same row in the table. So we've created a table name. Now we need to put some columns in our table. So I'll add the first column, and this I want to be an index column. So I'm going to give it a name of point index. Then I want a column for point name, and another for point value. One for point timestamp, and finally one for the point quality. So that's defined the names of the columns within our table, but before we go ahead and create the table, we need to define the data types for each of the fields within the table. So the first one I'd mentioned was a key field, and the DataHub has provided us with a data type of integer What this means is we'll get an incrementing integer number as the key field reference on each row that we add to the database. So now I want to choose which data point I want to log in the database. For this example, I'm going to choose the ramp1 point. So when defining the point name, I'm going to click to choose point, and you'll see the DataHub has filled in the point name for us. And the property I want to choose is the name, and its data type is a varchar or string. Now, depending on the data type you choose, the DataHub will guess at an appropriate data size for you. So if I do the same thing again for point value, and the point value is going to be a double, and then for point timestamp, and this is going to be a date time, and finally for point quality, and again this is going to be a varchar. So that's defined the name of our table we want to create, the headers for each of the columns, and the data types for each of the fields within the columns. So now I can go ahead and click on Create Table, and when these group buttons gray out, that successfully created the table within the database. Now I'm going to click down here on Create to save this information and create a configured action. So right now you'll see that we're writing to this database, this table within the database, and we're writing values for this point. But you'll notice we don't have a trigger or condition event configured just yet. So let's go ahead and configure that now. If we click on trigger, a trigger event within the DataHub is an event which actually triggers the DataHub to write to the database. We have three types of trigger event we can define. A point change, that is to say, whenever we trigger whenever the value of a point changes. A repeat timer, so for example we can trigger the event every 5 seconds. Or a time of day, so we could say every day at midnight we want to trigger our configured action. For this video, I'm going to come back and choose a point value. And I could choose the value for ramp1, the point we want to log to the database, but you don't have to, so in this case I'm going to trigger from a different point, this one being the random1 point. So now I will click on Modify, and that adds our trigger point. At this stage, this is all we really need to do. If we wanted to go ahead, we could click on Apply, and the DataHub would start logging data to the DataHub. Every time the value of random1 changed, it would log the value of ramp1 into our database table. But I want to show you how we can configure a condition statement. Now, condition statements are evaluated every time the DataHub trigger event fires, and the database will only get a new value, the DataHub will only write to the database if the condition statement is true when the trigger event fires. So as an example, I'm going to set up a trigger event and say that I want to write new values for ramp1 every time the trigger event fires. I'm going to evaluate the value of sine1 and write to the database if sine1 is greater than 35. So just to review, what we've done is we're saying we're going to watch the value of random1 in the data hub, and every time value for random1 changes, we're going to evaluate our condition statement. And if sine1 is above 35, then we will write the value for ramp1 into the demo table within our MySQL database. So at this stage, like I say, we can go ahead and click Apply. But before I do that, I just want to come back and I want to turn on diagnostics within the script log. Now, I want to do that so that we can see values being written into the database. And you'll see in a second. So I'll come back to my configuration interface, and let's click Apply. And right away, if we watch here, we should see some values being written to the database table. And there we are, we're seeing several insert commands. If I come back and show you the data values again, you'll notice that when sign1 is less than 35, it doesn't matter how many times random1 is changing, data will only get written when sign1 is above 35. And there we go. So that shows our trigger condition being evaluated. So let's go take a look at the data in our database. I'll open up the MySQL workbench, and here's our test database. And under here you'll see here's the demo table we created. And if I evaluate this query expression, then you'll see here are all of our table headers that we defined. And here are the data values being logged into the database. We have 21 of them right now. If I come back and run this query again, we might have, you see we've had a few more added to the table since then. So that's a quick look at how to configure the DataHub for its most common setup, really, for logging historical data to a database, where we log a new value to a new row in the table each time we log data. In our next video, we'll take a look at another approach where we actually use an existing table and we write values into the same row. So in effect, we modify the value for a same row in a database each time. I just wanted to reiterate that the condition statement is purely optional. We could have just triggered every time random1 fires, we could have written to the database, but I wanted to show you how tightly we can control the write to the database using a condition statement. If you have any more questions, then you can read a lot more about this in the DataHub documentation, which is available online, or you can email us at support@cogent.ca. Thanks very much for watching.